Hi everybody, I hope everyone's doing well. This video I will be sharing with you guys my review on the Tom Ford Orchid Haze Palette, as well as show you guys how I created this eye look with it. So if you guys are interested, do stick around. So I'm going to begin on the basics of what you get with the product, as I always do. And you get 10 grams with this product. It is a quad and it comes in this velvet pouch, as most luxury beauty palettes come in. And this is how it looks like. You get the Tom Ford logo there, and it's just a beautiful compact palette. What I like about this compared to a lot of the other luxury ones is how large and very useful that this mirror actually is. And then you get two brushes that come with it. Two of the brushes, well, both the brushes have a very similar kind of end, and this is the sponge dip tapered end. And on the other side, you get one that is like a blending brush. And the other one is also a tapered or a finer point sponge tip that you can actually use as an eyeliner applicator, although I didn't use it this time. Just judging from the quality of the brushes, I think they're actually pretty useful. They're not the type that they just throw in there for you to really just ignore. You can actually really use these brushes. So you get four shades with it, two shimmer shades and two matte shades. So the shimmer shades are the one on top, and it is this light off-white shade, this smoky taupe. You get a matte medium dusty rose pink and this dark brown grayish matte shade. So I'm gonna show you guys how I created this look from scratch. Shades right here. You have the lightest one, which is a shimmer. You have the medium one, which is like a matte. You get this shimmer shade right here, which is like a taupe, and this is the one right here. I don't know if you guys can see that with my lighting. And the darkest shade is this one right here. So you get two shimmer shades, which are the ones on top, and then two matte shades in the bottom. So I chose this palette specifically because it appealed to a more neutral tone, which is usually the kind of palettes that I gravitate towards, especially when I'm trying out a new brand for the first time, just because it's safe, I suppose. I think the matte are absolutely beautiful. I like them because they really, what you get, the color that is on the pan is what you get when you apply the color on your lid. I like the shimmer shades at the same time because the shimmer that they give is a very sophisticated shimmer. You can see how it creates this beautiful sheen that is not sparkly. It is not powdery. I did not get any fallout. Although when you initially pat the brush in the pan, there is a slight, I mean, some of the powder does seem like it scatters a bit, but once you apply it on the lid, it honestly stays put. I did use a primer. I used the Benefit primer. But I think even without that, it worked absolutely well. There was very minimal fallout and it was very easy to apply. retails for $78, which is, I think, in terms of price points in the spectrum, really clearly falls within the higher end. Let's say Dior and Chanel palettes, which are really the more common premium ones. So for the Dior Quince, which is you get 5 shadows, these retail for $58 and you get 6 grams. So you get 4 grams less. And with the Chanel quads, you get 1.2 grams, which is even less. And this retails about the same, I think $59. So basically the same price point. What is great about the Tom Ford, yes, it's about $20 more, so it's quite a jump, but at the same time you get much more product than the two previous brands. So that is about it. I'm impressed with the product. I know that it's gotten a lot of rave reviews, but I've held off quite a while because of the steeper price range and the amount of products I have. Sometimes you don't really know if you need another palette. And I was quite apprehensive because I do love the Dior Quince, but I would have to say that the Tom Ford palettes definitely have a new thing to offer. I like the fact that in spite of having a much higher range in price, you do also get a lot of actual product, a lot more actual product in terms of grams. And overall, each shadow from this quad I thoroughly liked. I liked how they applied, I liked the color payoff, and I like the fact that there was no fallout. So I hope you guys found that interesting and informative. Thank you for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day or a great evening.